In today's video, we'll be making, drum roll please, the Rick and Morty movie app using the official Rick and Morty API. Hopefully you are excited for this, guys. And by the way, this is the demo, so we can pull out the character's name, the status, if they are alive, the species, if they are human or alien. And we have this clean looking UI, and we're going to do this using just the API and just few lines of CSS. So as you can see, we have the image centered there, looking nice, some space between each card, and we can see each character, their status and their species. We can do a lot more with this, but this is the first part of this API introduction. We should just get you familiar with APIs, and it's fun to build, so we're going to do it. Rick and Morty is my favorite series of all time, and hopefully you will enjoy this. If you are new to the channel, this is kind of what we do. We build projects, exciting projects. I have courses so that you can learn. Then after that, we just go into building a ton of projects with that. So if that sounds exciting to you, hopefully you will remember to hit that subscribe button before you just skip out and leave the channel. So I post new tutorials every day on your favorite technology and tech stuff. Shout out to Medallion, who just won himself a GitHub collaboration on any project of his choice. If you would like to win the same, just head down and leave your views on any video, and you could win yourself a collaboration on any topic you ever wanted, any project you ever wanted to build. I'll collaborate with you and we'll crack that up and finish it. And yay, amazing. So if you missed this, this is just an open index.html. It has links to bootstrap.css. You can use the CDN. It has links to the app.js, which has nothing, and the styles.css, which is blank. I'm not going to write out this HTML. Just look at it. There's a div with a nav sticky top and an image in there for the logo, which you will see shortly. There's the logo that's on the nav bar, and that's the background, but we haven't implemented the background yet. Then here I have a div called nav item with the Rick and Morty title. Then in here is the important part. This is the div. Make sure the ID is card group on that div, because we'll later use it in JavaScript. So this is the extension I love to use. It really helps you to just test out APIs. So I'm just going to send a request and look at the JSON that it gets back to me. This is a very nice documentation, and it's an easy to work with API. Their documentation is really nice. I think if you really want to get into APIs, this is the first place you really ought to learn. If you don't learn from the Rick and Morty API, you will never learn APIs. Go become a monk. Okay. So really, this is really simple. We're just going to do a simple get request, get some data, and then print it back to the screen. I'm just going to head over to my app.js, where all the magic happens. Then we're going to do a fetch request. Then we're just going to open up curly braces and just pass that in. Then after this, we can do a dot then, which is essentially saying, okay, you've sent the request. Whatever we get back, we're going to get back a response. To that response, what we want to do, because this response is back, yes, we are happy, we have data, but quite frankly, this data cannot be understood. So we want to turn this into JSON, which is a JavaScript object, which we can now be able to view and interpret. Okay, hopefully you understand that. We can then do another dot then pass in data, which of course, what we want to do with this data is just, we want to create cards which will have this data inside. So we just close that dot then up. Then down here, what we want to do is now start building up what actually comes back from there. So we're going to do a function, and we're going to call this cards, the same as up there. And I'm going to pass in stuff just to show you that it doesn't really matter what you name it. I'm going to do const card container. Then what I'm going to do is document.get the query selector, which is the ID. So remember the ID back in the HTML, the ID is card group. Then just close that up. Then what you want to do is console.log this out and do stuff. Okay. But you know what? Let's just complete doing this entire thing. You know what? Just cut that out. I need to make this video as short as possible. Okay. So I'm not going to cut out the console.log. I'm just going to write underneath it. So let's just do stuff dot. What we're going to do right now is do a for each, so that it, what will return, it will return characters. So we want for each character, we want to put each character in each own card. Hopefully you're getting me. So it's going to loop all through all the information we get back, and for each character it's going to do a container, the card container. Then in here again we'll just repeat card container dot inner html. And what we want to add to this, we want to add a div. That's what we want to do. So use this, it's kind of the first button at the left side. What is the left? No, the right corner top of your keyboard to spawn up these little hyphen things. So what we want to do is create a div with a class of, let's say, card. By the way, this is Bootstrap. Bootstrap, I used it so that we wouldn't have to do most of the styling ourselves. So inside the h2 you want to pass in character name, so character dot name, and just close that h2 out. Then down here what you want to do is create a h4 which will have the characters. I don't know, let's do the status if it's male or female or alive or dead. So let's just do the status if the character is alive or dead. Wooba wooba dum dum, I'm trying to break. So just take that out. So we're going to change this from status to species, so we know if it's alien or human. Hopefully this is self-explanatory stuff. I think, is it self-explanatory? Who knows? Hopefully I'm trying to make this as clear as possible so that you can just get right into APIs. If you're loving this content, I will really insist you subscribe, because tons of content like this drop down on this channel every single day. And you all just view and you just left. I mean, some subscribe, but most just view and just download source code from GitHub. It's okay. So what you wanna do after you have done the image tag? What you wanna do is close that div up and do a break tag so that you'll have like a small space after each and every div. Then what you want to do is close that up. Okay, this should work now. And there we go, we fetched like an array. If you go back and look at your console, you'll find a ton of information, but I will do that to just shorten this video. So what you want to do is some global styling font family. We're going to do the sheriff himself, the h1. I just want to put in a color of white. Then what I want to do is do the cards. So I'm just going to do a maximum width of about 450 pixels so that it doesn't go the entire screen, padding to give a little space to the elements within it, the image, the text. The h4, I just need this color to be green. Then down here I'll just style what's left. Okay, let's do body down here. Okay, the body will take in quite a lot of styles because that's what has everything. So I'm just going to do the URL to specify the image, and all these images will be down in the GitHub repo. You can just go Google Fortune Codes, because all the source code to all our projects are in one GitHub repository anyway. So you can just head over to my GitHub. And if you don't already follow me on Twitter, Fortune the Dev 1, I think. Yeah, yes, Fortune the Dev 1. Just go follow me on Facebook. What the Facebook? It's Fortune Langat. EP, so that you can get updates on every video before it actually lands on YouTube. Okay, we're pretty much done with everything. But that nav bar sucks. Let's do some styling. Justify content, space between. And then that will just get rid of all the space between it and just push everything, and it will look nice. For the span tag, we'll just do a color of crimson. And then anything left to style, maybe none, nothing left to style. So that's it. Refresh that and boom. We have this amazing looking build using the API. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. You can do a lot more with this. We're going to have part 2. You can request it in the comments if you want to see a better.